Hier achter mij ligt Silicon Valley, midden in de staat Californië in de Verenigde Staten. En als autoliefhebber ben ik hier een beetje met dubbele gevoelens. Want als er één plek is in de wereld waar je nog ongegeneerd kunt genieten van auto's met 6-cilinder en 8-cilinder verbrandingsmotoren, dan is het wel hier. Behalve als het aan de bedrijven hier in deze vallei ligt, want die zijn hard bezig om de toekomst van deze auto's drastisch te veranderen. En dat maakt mij als journalist juist weer extra geïnteresseerd, want er vallen heel veel verhalen te halen. En daarom duiken we de komende tijd in Silicon Valley. Waar ligt de toekomst van de auto? Voor deze aflevering zijn we onderweg naar Menlo Park, waar het Koreaanse Hyundai een Amerikaanse vestiging heeft. Aan de buitenkant van het pand zie je het er nergens aan af, maar dit is toch echt de plek waar Hyundai Ventures de toekomst van de auto onderzoekt. Door de industrie en andere bedrijven goed in de gaten te houden, hoopt het merk op tijd aan te kunnen haken bij de juiste ontwikkelingen.
One example would be battery technology is probably a great example where we are looking at battery electric vehicles and we want to look at the next generation technology, so going beyond traditional lithium ion into the next generation lithium battery.
Yeah.
And so the battery team in R&D division has a set of companies that they're interested in globally, and
right.
The ones in the US they would help us, well they would identify those and then we would say okay, we can assist or support or lead in the discussion of those tech companies or battery companies. It caused me to look at the broader picture of battery technology. What I realized was that the cost improvements have been dramatic. Even compared to 8 years ago, what the experts would believe, the cost per, say, kilowatt hour, we've really beaten those forecasts.
Right.
And if we follow that trend, we get to a point where we get to gas prices being, let's say, roughly the same, we get to parity or even better than parity in terms of sort of the cost of an ICE, internal combustion
right.
engine vehicle.
In terms of usage.
In terms of usage, right. So at that point, then a lot of things can change at that point where we have a fairly dramatic increase in the market demand for these vehicles.
And when will that point be, you know? What do you think?
The projection, I would put it comfortably, I would say 2025 would be my comfortable sort of statement about, okay, this is where we get to an inflection point where these vehicles are no longer have to be subsidized in the marketplace. They can compete toe-to-toe with combustion
right.
engine vehicles, right?
Op dit moment moet Hyundai, als maker van relatief betaalbare auto's, het nog heel sterk hebben van mensen die auto's in bezit hebben. Omdat er volgens mensen zoals John Su de komende jaren veel gaat veranderen, zal ook Hyundai een andere koers gaan varen.
We get to a territory where car makers are less experienced in my personal view than we are accustomed to.
Right.
So
you're turning from a product type of company to a service kind of company.
Correct, right. With product being a key enabler, right? We can't ignore that. And there's a lot of fundamental things that are important for that.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, yes, it's the service angle which makes it distinctive. I think its ability to be flexible in the types of services it can offer will set them apart.
Okay.
Right? Maybe not the specific service, but the ability to be flexible and customizable is the key, right? It's even key in my view, in personally owned cars today, because the ultimate OEM is one that can make a SKU of one, right?
Okay.
Which is a long-held dream by manufacturing engineers, automotive manufacturing engineers. Their dream is to anybody can order any configuration at any time and make it with the same value as you would if you were making 300,000 of the same copy.
Right.
Now, that day has not happened yet. But that is indeed the goal of car industry today. It's definitely a funky idea. There's no doubt about it, it's a funky idea. Right?
Yeah.
But I love funky. Funky ideas are good. You gotta
yeah.
have a funky idea, because if you don't have a funky idea, then you don't have a chance to do anything else. My hope is that the funky idea becomes something more, you know, can be realized into something useful, right?
En dat terwijl Hyundai zichzelf juist meer dan ooit aan het positioneren is als een merk waarbij emotie en rijbeleving een rol speelt. Het bedrijf lanceert binnenkort de sportieve N-modellen en wil het luxe Genesis-label uitbreiden. Maar volgens John Su zal Hyundai zich niet zozeer op die vlakken onderscheiden van andere automakers.
The battle is going to be on the interior experience. So the experience that you and I would have while inside that vehicle is where that will be defined.
Like interior entertainment?
Could be entertainment, could be one feature. Certainly comfort would be another, you know, probably aspect of that.
Yeah.
Other kinds of, I guess information of different types that's made available to you. The type of things that you can do in the car, and obviously not just reading books or watching movies, but maybe like you and I can be in airplanes, we can be productive and, you know, for better or for worse, do work on the airplane, right?
But that's a very different future compared to the 250 horsepower i30N that you're developing now.
Yeah, it is. And so I would say there certainly would be, I'm sure, a customer segment that wants that 250 horsepower is not going to be, you know, nearly enough for them. They'll probably want 1,000 horsepower, manual, you know, no nanny controls on that thing.
Right.
I'm sure there'll be people like that, for the foreseeable future. But there'll be people that want this ultimate comfort and smoothness, and I don't want to touch the controls ever. I think there's a market for people who want that N brand or the Genesis brand or what have you, or the whatever we end up calling our AV brand or Ioniq brand, that kind of thing.
Right? So there will be several brands in the future, you think?
Probably, it's my guess. I think the whole idea of what a brand is will probably evolve because of customizability and because of technology. I think brands themselves will probably change. Some will be traditional. I think that'll be still there, but I think the buyer of the future will be different than it is today.
Hoe de autokoper of bezitter van de toekomst precies zal veranderen is ook voor Hyundai voorlopig gokken. Maar als het aan Hyundai Ventures ligt, pakt het bedrijf alle kansen aan om geld te verdienen aan diverse vormen van mobiliteit. Wat John Su betreft komt het opportunisme terug dat de autowereld in het begin kenmerkte. En daarbij worden letterlijk alle oplossingen serieus onder de loep genomen.
The limitation of wheeled vehicles is the fact that they need surface to go on, typically fairly smooth surface.
Yeah.
And there's a finite supply of that, and there always will be. And so while I do anticipate that wheeled vehicles will be useful for the foreseeable future, the limitation is on, because they require surface, then they're fundamentally limited. It goes against the anywhere, anytime, by anybody, to any place,
right?
Because not every place in the world has a road to it. Thank
you still
God.
Can't go as the crow flies.
I can't go to Mount Everest on a road, and I never want to go to Mount Everest on a road, right?
Will there ever be a Hyundai that flies then?
You can never say never, because the future is unpredictable. But I would say if it means that it's a means by which people can say, we can, you know, safely effectively bring people in, yeah, I think we should consider that. If it involves transportation of people, maybe not, except for like exploration purposes, but real, just maybe regular life, for lack of a better phrase, then it's something that we'll look into.
Okay.
Yeah, right. So, you know, we're not going to be SpaceX building rockets to supply ships to the International Space Station. However, if you get to a point where there's a regular shuttle to and from, I don't know, let's say everybody's favorite today is Mars, then that might be something we get into, right? Because it's right that we're transporting people to and from a place, and we'd like to do it in a safe and practical way.